This illustration is about the analysis of two blocks in equilibrium. Here the figure shows two blocks of masses 10 kg and 35 kg supported at rest by strings held by buoys A and B. We are going to find the force exerted by buoys A and B via these strings connected to the blocks. So, to analyze the situation, first we need to draw the free body diagrams of a block of 10 kg and 35 kg. So, if we draw a free body diagram of 10 kg block, here we can see it is experiencing downward its weight, that is 10 g, or we can write it 100 newton. We take g as 10. And one tension would be acting in it toward a 35 kg block. One tension is due to the force exerted by buoy. And another tension is acting toward the suspension point. So here we can see this angle is given to us as 37 degree and this angle is 60 degree. So we take this tension as T1, this as T2 and this as TA. We can simplify the situation by resolving and balancing all forces, because block of 10 kg is at rest. Similarly, if we draw the free body diagram of a 35 kg block, you can see it is experiencing 35 g or 350 newton force in downward direction as its weight. In this direction, it is experiencing a tension which is held by buoy B. And this is the direction which this string is connected, which is having a string tension T2. Here also we have taken tension and this string as T2 and the string here is ideal. And this tension which is due to the force applied by buoy B. Here we are given that this angle is 45 degree and this angle is 37 degree. So we can write now for equilibrium of blocks. If we balance the forces here, you can see in horizontal and vertical direction we can balance. First, let us balance in vertical direction. It is T cos 60 degree, which is T1 multiplied by 1 by 2, is equal to the downward force acting on it is 100 plus this T2 cos 37 degree. So, this T2 multiplied by 4 by 5. So, this is our first equation. In horizontal direction, we can write left side is the force exerted by buoy A, which is TA. And on right hand side, it is T1 sine 60 degree, which is root 3 by 2, plus this T2 sine 37 degree, which is T2 multiplied by 3 by 5. Say this is our equation 2. And here from first equation, we substitute the value of T1 over here, we get TA in terms of T2. So, we can simplify this again. Here we can write from equation 1, the value of TA is, we can substitute the value of T1 as this 200 plus 8 by 5 T2. So, we can write this as 200 plus 8 by 5 T2. Multiplied by root of 3 by root 3 divided by 2 plus T2 multiplied by 3 by 5. So, if we get the value of T2, we can directly get the value of force exerted by buoy A. So, now for 35 kg block, we can further balance the forces. So, this will give us T2 cos 37 degree, which is T2 multiplied by 4 by 5 plus this TB sine 45, which is 1 by root 2, is equals to 350. Say this is our equation 3. And in horizontal direction, we can write T2 sine 37, which is T2 multiplied by 3 by 5, is equals to TB cos 45, that is TB multiplied by 1 by root 2. So, here TB multiplied by 1 by root 2, we can write as 3 by 5 T2. So, we can see from equation 3, here we are getting T2 multiplied by 4 by 5 plus this is 3 by 5 is equals to 350. So simplifying the value of T2, we are getting this 7 by 5, so this is 250 Newton. So if we have got the value of T2, we can continue here one by one. So here we can see from equation of TA, here you can see the value of TA we are getting. If we substitute the value of T2 as 250 Newton, this will be 250 by 5 is 50 multiplied by 8 is 400 plus 200 is 600 by 2. So this 300 root 3 plus T2 is 250 multiplied by 3 by 5 is 150. So this is in Newton would be the result of force exerted by boy A on 10 kg block. Similarly from equation 3, or directly we can use this equation 4. So from equation 4 we can directly see the value of TB we are getting is 3 root 2 by 5 multiplied by T2, which is 250 Newtons. So this is giving us 150 root 2 Newton. This is another answer of the problem, which is the force exerted by boy B on the string.